Let's start this evening a little bit shorter and much different than other from the beginning to the end. It's really a special pleasure to have on my right side some young boy who started his career with me when he was 12. I remember all my life one small guy who running behind his brother and other players who played generation 1972. He's born 1976. He was 4 years younger than them, but he don't want to give up. He ran behind them all the time, never with any sound. Man or boy, without any comment. And that was the beginning of really a long and very successful career. We started together in Shupa Aleksandrovac, from a very small city with 5,000 people, 7,000 people, and we believe that we can do everything. With a group of players, we started with 14 players, and from these 14, 16 actually, from these 16, 14 was the champion of Yugoslavia and Serbia, who won this amazing final. And we were unbeaten team at that time, like 15, 17, 19, until generation stayed. My personal dream as a coach was to have two players from this generation in Sydney Olympic game. Fortunately, I did just 50%. Ivan was there. Another guy was really accelerant, who was best player and this time captain of the team, never came to the same level. Some of you play with him and you know him personally. But we dream and we believe that we can change handball in our city, we can change handball in our country together. And handball pathway lead him over Jelena Chernish, connected with the really best player on planet Earth. He worked with Zoran Živković and Jelena Chernish, stays 7 years there. Then goes to Barcelona to one of the greatest handball coach in handball history, Rivera. Then goes to Gummersbach in Germany, play with Zed Hasanefendić, another great coach. From Gummersbach moved to West Brom, stay 5 years there with also one amazing coach like Lajos Močaj. And his career was really long. He played also once again in Spain, in Italy on the end. And he played more than 200 times for national team of Yugoslavia, won two bronze medals in 1999. Egypt in 2001 in Paris, this crazy semi-final, and he played actually together. He was roommate with Carlos Ortega, stay here like a guest, and then he played against him in Olympic game in Sydney for the bronze medal. Unfortunately, Carlos won this game. Unfortunately for Carlos, Carlos won bronze medal, even stay without Olympic medal, but Daniel Constantini voted him like one of the best players on this Olympic game. He was also voted like member of first seven in German Bundesliga. He was a champion in Spain, Hungary many times. He won Cup Winner Cup. He played many, many international games. And the characteristic of Ivan was that he never gave up. His position was back player. I just want to say for some of you who practice last few days on unusual position like Peter on left side, right side, center position. Ivan can play any of back position, even pivot position. Ivan play in our team like right back, even his position was left back because he knows how to play this position, and then he play like a center player, left back, and every coach on where he play was extremely satisfied because he was a great defender and attacker who played for his team, played with one of the best scorers in the history of Korea, guy called Jun, who was the best scorer by far in German Bundesliga, and he adapted the player and made the player around him better. I really enjoy every moment on his career, and I really enjoy tonight the table. Ivan is here with us. That was just introduction. We will discuss. It will be interactive discussion, an open discussion about professional coach life and something with Marco and me to discuss life after the career, because that's the moment what will come. It will come from some of us and it will come for you in the future. Ivan, thank you for coming and you're very welcome with us.
Good evening to everybody. I'm very, very glad to be in this camp who become a traditional camp and, for my opinion, one of the best handball camp in the world. This is not a small opinion just to make pleasure to people, but I'm sure to knowledge that we can get to this camp with Dragan, with Carlos, and something that we can really enjoy. Also want to say thank you to Dragan, not only because he called me to come and he seemed to meet all of you, because he was, like he said, my first coach who have most important influence to continue. What I want to share with everybody is that this period of the career of the season, when it stopped the season, when we can say that we hit the point of the season, is for my career was the most important period to development of the knowledge to be completely ready for the season. Because of this, I want to insist to each player to take this this period here, not just to look and just to be friendly, but to take most what he can to be completely ready for next season. He can say that when I was played, I used this period to grow up maximum my physical potential, to work off this maximum power. Because during the season, this is very difficult. So because of this, you must use all exercise in the training to speak with coaches what you can be, and to use this period to grow up maximum, especially about the physical level, this aerobic potential, and especially for the power of the legs here. Because handball today is not easy to play just to run. You must be absolutely more very strongly. If you look who is best player today, is Karabatic, is 90% physically. After the results of the club depend on the coach or the competition, but if we speak about individual level and development of individual player, you must take care too much about this, especially physically, and of course, because of this, I want to make this influence, like I would say, to use this time to work maximum, to speak with, especially with him, how you can use this time to be ready, and how to continue after during the season to keep this and to make this objective that you have for next year. If we speak about what is most important to be good player, to be good sportsman, I read one newspaper text, Cristiano Ronaldo. I don't like him like sportsman, he's not a good example like really sportsman, but he say what every big sportsman think, that most important thing is to have one objective, what you want to success in your career. Believe or not believe, I'm sure that every big sportman here objective what he want to do, especially for his career, I can say for next 10 years during the career. After one objective, what he want to get for 4 years in here, and after especially what he want to success in next year. And this time what you are here, in this training, in this atmosphere of Hamburg, you must think about this, what you want to get next year in this time. How much you want to have your results better, and how you want that your muscles and your motoric is better than now. And this is good time to think about this. Because when the season starts, when pressure starts, it's not really the time about it. So I'm here to answer about professional, about careers, about sport life, about modern sport life. I can't speak so much about technical, tactical, Alejandro, because here with Dragan, with Carlos, they are best coaches in the world, they can say everything. But I can maybe say about the life of big sportmen. It really can be good picture that you can get how they are living, what they are doing to help, to can use in your training, in your everyday life. So, this is for the beginning.
How difficult was it to adjust to playing to different leagues? I mean, you played for many teams all around the world. How difficult was it to adjust?
It's a very good question. But the first question is this story again about the objective, what you want to success. I was really one type of player who work a lot. And when I see who can work more than me, I think nobody can work more than me. Because I remember my story. My mother called me 2 o'clock during the lunch. I was in the sun and I spoke for doing something. And she called me again in 10 o'clock in the evening. I was in the same sport hall. She said, "You are again in sport?" Yes. And I can say during some parts of my life, I worked 7, 8, 9 hours during the day. And I thought this is the maximum what one player can do. But, 2 years ago, I read one book. Book is about Novak Djokovic. Very interesting book. I want to support everybody to read this book. It's about food, but during the book we can see many, many important things about success. And he say, believe or not believe, how much he worked during the day. And this is he worked 14 hours for one day. 14 hours. So this is not only physically work. We can say, but this is, we can say, thinking about career and about sport and about tennis, 14 hours. And what we can do, we can sit after this training today, it was excellent training. We can sit now in Facebook 3 hours like this and we think we recover our body, recover our energy. But we don't do like this. If we want to take advantage of this training, we must think what we was on this training. Where we was, what we can do better next time. What, which point can be better to take our objective, what we have for this year. And Novak Djokovic is an example, he think about this, he think about meditation, about yoga, about recuperation on real level, about stretches. He wake up, he look. I remember one story when we play best game in Barcelona, last 8 in Champions League, stay last 8 teams we played. First game was in Barcelona. I didn't was so ready because I think today one player must be like one coach. He must prepare himself with videos, with the statistics. Because it's not players like before. Players just follow what coach say and they don't think anything. And coaches have papers, coaches here, and player is free. No. I believe in 10 years player will be really in school, players educated completely, like coach must be completely educated about everything, about and must prepare himself. I didn't was so prepared and I come to this game and this player Ike Romero. He played two seasons excellent, even like now, Karabatic, so strong, so hard. And our school was to make a lot of faults. Yugoslav schools is play humble with football. And he start to me, I start to him and he broke me 2 minutes after, in the beginning. Again I come to game after, he start, I start to him to close this and he again broke me again 2 minutes. So he come, I get a red card after 40 minutes, I was lost for this game. But I come to revenge to Westbrook and I start to think and to look this video day and night to see what was the problem. And I have one idea how, because I knew that he will do the same. And now I prepare myself. He start to me, I start to him, but I stop 1 minute, 1 meter before. And he go there and I go there, I just follow him. And he was so surprised, what is now? So now first game he make 10 goals and second game he didn't make any goals. Not because of me, of course, but I think this psychological was because he was prepared to do the same. And now he can't do this and automatically he's not ready. He don't know, he must think during the game is going. He must think what to do next. Because of this I take Novak Djokovic, we speak, everybody speak, players is really obligation now to think this 10 hours during the day. To look video, to look his self video, not to make pressure to himself. Because we usually think if I break now, I humble, I will relax if I lie down like this. Not to make pressure, but I think if we make order in our career, if we make order step to step our career, this is less pressure than we have now. Pressure is coming when we are not ready. And because we feel that we are not ready sometimes and we feel pressure because we will not play good. So, every one step what we do can be really one good step to make stress, to make pressure and to be better. This is our best. But he asked me for difference in every league, and there is difference in every league. We know what is the difference in Spain if we are playing very fast and very this explosive power is very important in Spain and very cleverly in the play two against two. Spain handle is only two against two. Every tactic is how to make space two against two. German is completely one, not so fast, there is also speed, but is more power, how to be power, because it's very interesting to play in Germany. Everyone can play, this is one dream sport life in Germany, because every game is full. Sport hall, every game is statistic, how you make, how people like you in the game, not like in Serbia, when you are good, they like to to put you down. In Germany, no, if you are good, everybody like you, everybody, you are recognized, you are lovely to the fans, to the president. And in Hungary, there is also one good, because there is two good clubs, this is Szeged and Veszprém, and one good competition, and life is nice, there is nice girls, there is very nice this food. And I suppose everybody to success, to catch many different, many leagues, but first I suppose to work on yourself, to not like now, I'm now, for example, a manager for the players, and players call me, find me on club. I don't like this, I like that. He break on himself, he is better, and club will fall, he will not. I find now club and I survive in this club and after the same. If you are good, if you break on yourself, club will fall you. And you don't need manager, you don't need manager. And the player don't need to think about managers, about this. They must think only about, like Novak Djokovic said, how to work 10 hours, not to press themselves, how to to care Charlie's to patient to do it.
You just talked about objectives. That's very important. Did you have like objectives when you were young, and what kind of objectives you had?
When you are young, you must get one objective for your career. What you want to do, to be national player, or to be best player in your country, or to be. And after this general objective, you must do this period like what you want to do for 4 years. Every coach has this. You can speak with your coaches how they make macro cycles. And player must do the same. Player must have his objective. And second thing is what you must do to make plan. How you can get this. And to think about this. If you make barrier in your head, you will have much more possibility to make your this objective physical. So start to do objectives, start to think about it, start to think especially what you want to do this season. After this season, July next year, what you want to have in your career. How much you want to be stronger, how much to be faster, and how much your value, financially value.
And what was your objective when you were young? Like big objective?
Yes. Something like this.
Something very big?
This my objective was I was really special, not only special player, special man, think of this way. I read a lot of psychology books at this time in my, when I was in 19 years in Indonesia, I live alone with some grandmother, it was difficult. And I read one book, How to Make Programmate Your Subconsciousness. And I sleep. I think half year the same dress of Barcelona, I buy the dress in Barcelona. So to then get after it. And after I forget about this. And after 5 years this happened. This is one way. I suppose everybody to make his object really on the paper or paint or put on his wall to remember everything. Not I repeat again, not to make pressure to yourself, just to have one energetic influence on you, to remember it always, that you can, and you can remember.
Any other question about the conditioning? He was playing in Spain, Germany and Yugoslavia and Hungary. In which of these countries you was the best prepared, you know? Did you have the best condition and training or the understanding?
I think about this question is all depend on the coach.
Yeah, I know that.
And coach, first coach planning. Depend who is, and we can't look about.
Yeah, but sometimes the player something like and something don't like. Where or in which club, if you think about your career, is everything was perfect?
Well, in Spain I have Valero Rivera, and good players, and we think preparation is hard, but not. It's very easy preparation during all summer, one training, 1.5 hour, 1 and 20 minutes. And very, very, very easy preparation, because he think, his opinion is to during all year to work, not during before the season to work hard, and after two, during all the year to work on the same level and to keep this relaxation. This is his opinion.
Yeah, but I think that this is not you, because you are a hard worker. And how you was feel after that training can stand, because it's not like your character, you know. You know, you are a hard worker, and then you train with the team which have just one training a day, and
yes, it's happened. Yes, that's it. If you ask about my personally, there is one very interesting story, funny story. Carlos Ortega, no, and all Barcelona, no. Because after this training, I go immediately to the fitness to work 2-3 hours more, of course. And I was one day too tired. I look TV on the fitness room. There is one space like this and one TV. And I fall asleep because and everybody go to fitness and they close the fitness. And I wake up in the dark. And I slowly start to go out to go out, and alarm start to ring, and police come to see me. And tomorrow morning, I explain, okay, no problem. But tomorrow morning, I come to the training, and everybody know about this thing. Policeman, they ask if this was really. This is this. Every player do like this, but we have in Barcelona, we have space free to fitness, to jacuzzi, to sauna, to, and we can spend all day. I was so bored. This was my second house. Okay, with sauna, with fitness,
stretches. But it was different when you play, when you train a lot, and when you train a little bit less, like in Spain. If you feel when you play this that you was trained less than normal.
Yeah, but for me personally, this is self confidence. If I work more, I feel more self confidence. For somebody else, for example, Aslan Hadji, he don't need to train so much. He show himself. He have this body who can make 7 goals, and he won't no problem to need to work like somebody. There is different type of players, but I think everybody must work or something, but they don't have. There is many space to work.
Yeah.
There is many possibility to work. And for example, in Germany, I work a lot with the coach, because my coach was a classic coach who don't have any less than 3 hours. But I was older, and for me was this was not good, because after I start to look out to relax myself. Because we start the season in October, and everything was completely dead. We just need to start to be, and we can't work. Okay, all season after the so there is training. This is the decision of trainer.
Yeah,
this is his decision how he will do it. Yes, I think it's very important. Most important is this to have basis to know about. It's most important, but I have luck to have Dragan with me his first 6 years. And was his basis, first basis for me. But I must be true that after every season is a decision if you will be on, especially this year, 1920. And I can say 80% of sportsmen will know how to. When is one decision time, who can push you up or who can block it. And for my statistics, because now this is my job. My job now is to be manager. And I want to explain after with what is not a real manager, but what we team. And statistic is that 75% of good talent, big player in this time. Much more talent don't suppose the for statistics. Much more talents who can in this time 1920 happen something. And this is my job now to be this manager, how to help in this decision time to play to success to cross this and to can express it the way that they can.
Different coach, you're been patient with different coach with different mind. You adapt yourself, or you and coaches must know you well, or you find middle solution between thing. You know, you play in German. After that, you go to Spain. After that, you go to the Hungary, and we have. Different way training and different thing. So you adapt yourself with this thing. But you told us now in Barcelona train 1 hour and a half, and after that you go for 2 hour to jump. That's something.
Dragan knows every coach is like me. I don't know why, but maybe I know because I adapt to every coach. What he wants, this is for me a big law. I don't say I think if coach say you must jump, I jump. Because of this, I was not so we can say not so big talent with my ex legs and my little bit back. But all coaches, when they make team, they call Lapis home because he will do, we know what he will do. And for this one, he had a little bit strange head, maybe he was a better player than me, they don't call that, call me, because I'm like this. I respect him, I respect his coach. I remember in one club, we have a big club. We have in 11 o'clock every morning drinking coffee. From 11 o'clock until 1:30, 2.5 hours, we speak about coach, how he's bad, he's thinking in this way. And I was 20 days, maybe two, three weeks after, I don't want to drink coffee. I don't want to speak about coffee. And every day, same story. He's like, our president is like this. And we turn around the same story and say, better to read some book. To listen to look some video or something, and to speak about how he's like me.
And when you go to the gym, the coach will tell you don't go or if you're free.
Anybody, any coach say anything. Because I want to advise to every player here to take career in their hands. Because I have one speak with one my friend. He say, you know, I work everything what my coach say me. Everything. He say me do 20 times this, I do 20 times this. And after 10 years, I look myself, I didn't success anything. Because of this, I want to support that everybody must take their career in their hands. And to be organizator to their hands. Coach have one good influence, that he think about more bigger story. Everybody must think about himself, about him objective, about him work, personal work, about where he is now, how he can grow, how to. And this is one responsibility of each one. If you just follow what coach say you, never you, every big player, make his career by himself. Think about his. Nobody success just to follow good course.
you just said that when you're 19 or 20 years old, that's a very important phase in your career. What are the most important things to do in that part of your career?
Most important in this career is to face yourself. If you really want to be and to decide that you want to success and that you want to be big, and that you want to do everything what you can to be big, so don't make middle position. Maybe I can, but if I can't, it doesn't matter. If I decision is very important, and in this time. It's not easy. Really, sport is precious, sport is hard things, but depend of decision of your responsibility, and you will find solution always. And always there is solution. Always there is. Will be pains, will be relation problems. But this is something more. Will be that people will say you don't know anything. Every sportman must face this. I was in Ish, was the best player. But every game, when I come to game, after 10 minutes they say, Lapčević, go out, you are a stupid man, you don't know anything yet. And they say to the coach, put him back, and everybody. And you must go home, you must cry a little bit, you must come tomorrow again, and again, and again. Every sportman has this problem. And don't think so much about coach, about think about how to build, how to find the friends. And not, okay, follow your coach, but think about also what you can do.
From the junior to the senior. And it's one difficulty how, because senior here they have experience, they are good, and they leave from this, they don't want to move. And you are young, you are sensitive, you don't want to disturb them, you don't want to be, okay, they are older, you are ashamed a little bit, and they don't give you a place. Also because they fight for themselves. But you must take this place. And if you are not strong psychologically, they will push you out, you will say, okay, I am going to do something else because I can't cross this. This is one step of psychology. Because you will see after in the world, because everybody fight for their place. Because people want to fight, want to survive. But life is not easy. The most important, all the players don't give you a chance. This is your time when you must play for senior team. When I came to Niš from Župa, they didn't give me a place to play. Everybody fight for their place. And I didn't play, but I go to fitness every day, for example. Or do something to don't lose my. I think that if you don't play, same thing. After the game, you must do one training. Not to, because happen you don't. Before game is one small training, one easy training. After you don't play a game, after Sunday you don't. Relaxing day after Monday they are relaxing, and you don't play, you lose 4 days. In 4 days you can you know what you can do for, if you compare it now, job is 14 hours of work, you lose 50 hours of work. And if you look at normal people who is working 8 days by hour, the sportsmen working 1.5 day by hour, there is many time. But I don't propose this physical work just to push, to be tired, to be injured. I supposed to think about psychologically, about, for example, today was very hard speed training, how to learn how to relax your body now after, how to learn this exercise of relaxation, how to look this mental training, who is projecting better taking object in order to. There is also psychological training, there is also looking video, there is also making plans. Everybody, every player can share one space in their room to write, to think, to make plans. And this is one job of management, to control how to lead your career. What I'm doing now to help each sport player to organize his career. And the real manager is this, he must not just to find club and to build trust, you must take care about completely the organization of your career, find solution for all problems in career, speak, support, make consulting, be real support of player.
I don't know if you remember or not, but you know, it's always you push the player. Then if you have a player, they push you back to be better. Push them to be better and then they push you because they become better and better. You have to be better to stay on the same level with them. And on that time, I read a lot. My players follow me and we play one tournament. In 3 days, we have to play 5 games. We need total 9 players and 2 of them was very young. And then I read a lot about ultimate training and we work in one small room there in Bruce, in the middle, this ultimate technique to relax ourselves, to play these 5 matches, because in the final they wait with Bojinović, you remember this team in final, and team who win will go to the competition, Yugoslavian competition. And we won them on the end, but they organize. If you remember, they qualified like organizer. It's important that you believe also in the things what you're doing. That you believe in yourself and things what you're doing. And no one, especially in that age, can push you from on your road. But you still believe. Even things, like Ivan says, are not perfect. No one is perfect. And sometimes look that coach push you so much or that nothing goes well and things are not good, but you can be just afraid if you don't work enough. Then you are in problem. But if results are not good, don't worry. If you play good, the result on the scoreboard is good. At the end of the story. And I was lucky really that their generation could believe. And we build ourselves like human beings also. Even English is not actually his best language. He speak better German or Spanish or even Italian or now French because he is very fond of love. We speak about a nice Hungarian woman, but I think Dragan is the person who has to speak about this. He found love in Spain. You met in Spain, yes. Yes. And now his father also. Career goes to the next step. And today we spoke also about something what coming after the sport. And that was something what I spoke with some of you, I will not say any name. When I asked you during these 5 days, what are you doing outside of handball? Because, you know, this sport is nice, but after the sport also, I mean the real life, some of us stay in sport, but most of the handball players and athletes do other things in life. You have also to think about this, to be responsible about your life.
Last question, to say something. One of the really special thing in the Islam, this evening. For me, I attended many courses, many seminars of Hashem, but it's the first time to listen from experience of professional, great professional men. Sometimes we hear from the coaches about their experience, but we have our own player. As it's useful for the players, it also is useful for us as coaches to deal with this, to know this life of professional players. So I say thank you for coming to this, thank you for our guest. And he said very, very important thing. I want to advise young players to look for real manager, as he said, not for agent. Put your future in the hand of real, honest manager, not agent. Because I think he knows what he said. Thank you.
Neću da pitam ko će se vama krenuti što najbolje.
Could not ask you, you want to use this opportunity?
Da ste izabrali da dođete na ovaj kamp samo da poslušate ovo što je rekao Ivan.
If you choose to come to this academy just to say this what Ivan says.
Radili ste više nego svi drugi koji odmaraju i
spavaju. Much better than some of the everyone else who stay at home or enjoy somewhere in some nice place.
Da vam nemoj učan da čujem ove riječi.
Mi je zvonio tu listan iz
Gorica. Fenomenalni osobi i sportista.
Kao ti special person and athlete.
Razmišljaj.
And think about it.
Hvala.
This is also the reason, sorry, that we don't have any more success like in Slavia and after that, so we are going to be able to do it. This is the reason why we cannot qualify and championship will be already called white card. Not only in men's, even in women's. Because there is no more divine person like him, no more persons who want to work on themselves. They're just waiting for the money and waiting for something else to happen.
Great, I will just add on Daniel words. Use this time every single moment because as you recognize, things going so fast. Carlos was with us, that looks like 5 years ago. Klaus passed Ljubljana this afternoon on his bike, send us mail, regards, Professor Alex. Marco will have tomorrow morning with your session and after this session has to leave us. And you know, use every moment to make connection, to make questions, to ask whatever you want, because time running so fast. And to remember this evening, I have a small present to Ivan. It was a pleasure to have you here. Thank you. About tomorrow, 8 o'clock is breakfast again, because we start at 9:30. Tomorrow in gym, Derek's session, gym session, gym instruction, it's better to say, with Marco, and see you on the morning at 8 o'clock for breakfast. Use now the opportunity to speak one-on-one or to stay with Ivan, because it's not every day to have.